Hello, there are a couple of more anomalies to share. Got the Tesla coil in resonance again, the ZVS board, the cap tuning board, same setup as before. We've got three rods in there, which are going through just through the air core of the Tesla secondary. They're not connected to anything at the bottom. They're purely capacitively coupled to the secondary. Those three are going into this coil, which I saw this Tesla Tech actually back in the summer. It inspired me to wrap this, which is six coils. There are three in the bottom which are wound counterclockwise, and there are three in the top which are wound clockwise. So I thought it was ideal for testing each of the outputs of each rod going through this. I merged the bottom three coils into one output, and they're going to that cap bank, sorry, that rectifier, and the top three are just inductively coupled to the bottom three, and one end of the wire is here with that neon on it, and the other end is just going into this rectifier, just to balance out the rectifier. That the other side is going to ground. That one wire is giving 370 volts thereabouts, and the other three over there are producing 355. These are all kind of standard numbers. Each wire would normally give at least that. But anyway, I noticed this. I thought, oh, well, there's nothing connected to the number two rectifier at all, apart from the ground. I've got the multimeter clips there, but that's it. Nothing else attached to it. I even disconnected the probe. Because it was grounded and I didn't want anything to be coming through that, and the probe, which is the blue trace, still insists that there's about 248 volts going through it, but it's not even connected. Anyway, so I thought, well, maybe it's residual voltage from the capacitor, so I thought, okay, well, I'll short it out and make sure there's nothing in it, which I did, like that, and it still insists that there's 1.3 volts there. So then pulling that off, and it immediately springs back to 66 volts or thereabouts. The only way that can be coming from is the ground. There is nothing else attached, nothing at all. So that was one interesting thing. Next is the other end of the three coils on the top. Remember, there's one going into that rectifier giving the 360 odd volts. And then the other one, I've got a probe on it here, and that's giving, what's that, 412 volts. And I just thought I'd put this bulb on it, and as I was putting it on, it takes about 90 volts to normally light this, and I noticed that it was lighting up with my hand on the glass, and I thought, well, oh, look at that. 400 volts. Cold stuff is interesting, huh? Anyway, I just thought I'd share that. Thanks very much.